Welcome to the Indian Express. Today, we are here to talk about an Islamic cleric in the United Arab Emirates who finds himself in trouble for having tweeted against the allotment of land for a temple in Abu Dhabi during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit to that country last month. I have with me Shubhajit Roy, who's done this story. Shubhajit, what exactly has happened?
Well, Raghavendra, when Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited Abu Dhabi and Dubai last month, the Crown Prince there announced allotment of land for a temple in Abu Dhabi. Mm-hmm. Now, this is the first temple in Abu Dhabi that is to be built. Following this announcement, one of the popular and well-known clerics, who is an Islamic scholar there, Sheikh Wasim Yusuf, he criticized this allotment of land and tweeted about it.
Okay.
Following the tweet, the UAE authorities took it very seriously, mm-hmm. and not just reprimanded him, but also he used to host a show on one of the TV channels,
okay.
Which was a religious preaching show and about interpretation of dreams for viewers, mm-hmm. show. That has been taken off air. So this is being seen as a action, taken by the UAE authorities.
Okay, so what exactly was the tweet about? What did he say that was found to be so offensive?
Well, Raghavendra, basically he did a tweet on last month, about August 18th, and the tweet was in Arabic, and it, when translated, says that all Muslim sheikhs agreed that building temples for infidels is forbidden. So this was like retweeted thousands of times and favorited several times. It went viral in the UAE social media there, and it created a lot of response. Now, this was objected to by one of the top UAE officials, who is a religious advisor to the Crown Prince. Mm-hmm. And the religious advisor, he basically said that such divisive and radical ideas do not belong in the modern world. Mm. And he condemned this act. And following this incident, Sheikh Yusuf's show was taken off the air. It was a popular show which was telecast about 3 days a week, every week. And it was taken off.
Okay, so why do you think the UAE authorities acted so promptly in this case? What's behind that?
That's the very important question, because what is happening is, with Prime Minister Modi's visit, mm-hmm. There is a renewed vigor into this relationship, where we as India want more security cooperation, more investments from UAE, and UAE wants to do more business with this, because it sees India as a big market for them, because they have like billions of dollars in their sovereign wealth fund, so they want to invest it here. So this cooperation, this bilateral relationship, has suddenly taken up at a very high level. And mind you, UAE is one of the closest allies of Pakistan. So from security cooperation point of view, its stance on terrorism is very important to us. It gives a message to the wider world that how UAE is partnering with us on Syria. So that's why it is reaching out to India and doesn't want such small incidents to affect the relationship at all.
The bilateral ties.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Interesting story, Shubhajit. Thank you for sharing the details with us. Thanks for watching.